Now, moving on to the lenses and starting with the L lens. So, after focusing the lens for best possible view, you can see the objects quite clear on the huge display. It is clear to see that it is written C301 and C160. And you can see how far the distance of the lens is from the PCB. Let's try and zoom it further. Here we get a working distance of 90mm to 300mm and a magnification of 60x to 240x with 3x digital zoom. Let's zoom it further and see how big we can see this component. You can see how clear and big it is now. The images are really sharp. I can clearly see the dirt between the two components, this one and this one, you see. So let's try and do further zoom, maximum possible. I think I've lost the component. I think this is it. These two are together. Well, every time it surprises me, we are even closer now. Yeah, this is the maximum that we are getting with the L lens. And if we want to go any further, we will have to change it. Now, you also get this remote with which you can do digital zoom. And go back to normal. Next, we have a resolution, EV exposure, date stamp, sharpness, freeze, contrast, and color. Normal white sepia. I prefer normal. Next, with the OK button, you can start the recording. And there you see the recording on the top left corner. And to take a picture, just press this button. Yeah, to stop the recording, press OK again. And these two are for the brightness. That is maximum brightness. This is normal. This is all about the lens L. Moving on to the lens A. The object distance for lens A is 12mm to 320mm with a magnification of 18x to 720x and again 3x digital zoom. So for the A lens, we will have to bring down the display and the lens quite close to the PCB for maximum magnification. Although this lens gives you the maximum working range. Let's go for maximum close-up directly. Wow, the sharpness is so nice. It couldn't be better. And this is still not the maximum. Let's go for maximum. You can even see the dirt that has been deposited on the terminals of the SMD. And this is the smaller one, not the bigger one. Now, let's remove the PCB and focus on a hair strand with this lens. Fascinating. Let's zoom it to maximum, turning off the lights. So that is the full 3x digital zoom. So moving on to the final D lens for maximum magnification, you can see the object working distance is only 4mm to 5mm and it gives you the maximum magnification of up to 2040x. So here we have this ant stuck to the sugar piece. You can see that it is trying to remove itself from the sugar. They're quite strong. It's amazing how it is doing it. Wow. Well, it is out of focus now. Let's zoom in. Let's go for its tail. I can see something flowing right here. Let's zoom in further. The zoom is very strong. There are some kind of nerves. There's something flowing inside. Let's go for maximum possible zoom. Yes, this is not the max. Maybe you can see it now. It's fascinating. That's the head. Wow, it is actually breaking itself. And wow, brilliant. Now it is finally free. It did it on its own, and that is amazing. Now guys, there is another attachment compatible with the D lens. It is for viewing the microscopic slides. So starting with the honeybee wing. Let's do full focus now. Next is the eye of a housefly. Whoa. What is this? That is so cool. At full zoom. Let's reduce the zoom a little bit. The quality is amazing. Moving on to the next one. Pine stem. Let's do full zoom. 2000x. Wow, it is so colorful. Moving on to the last organism, it is a living mosquito larva. You can see that it is excreting something. So cool. And at present, it is at minimum zoom. And that's its face. Yeah, now it is completely visible. It is a little difficult to focus on every part of its body. We can focus only on one part at a time. On the right, I believe, is the excretion. And now I'm focusing on its head. It's beautiful. We can even see the hair on its body. Let's zoom into maximum. I'm seriously in love with this microscope. Wow, it is still not full zoom, but I want to view it at this point as well. It has a weird looking head. It has a curious face. So that's the full view. Now I have this rainwater sample from 2 days back. So let's look into it. Oh yeah, I see something. I don't know what that is. And there are two of them. It's really difficult to see. Here I'm doing maximum possible zoom. Whoa, all these were living organisms. We can see that they're moving on its own. That is amazing. Oh, you can see there's something really big moving. There are so many different type of creatures moving over here. And on the left, you can see, although I'm not sure what it is, that's a cocoon. What kind of organism it is? It is very huge. Oh, it ate the smaller species. Oh no, that species came out. Oh, there's whole life in rainwater. I never thought about this. Oh, it is so amazing. Let's stir the water.
Now guys, I have another microscope AD207. Again, it is from Andon Star. And this one is smaller and less powerful. It is only 100x. So let's compare the two practically. So that's the difference between the two, and this one is still not at full zoom. So I would like to say that both are good microscopes, but this AD207 is obviously cheaper and less capability of zoom when compared to the bigger one. There you get a big display, which helps a lot, and you have three different types of lenses for maximum possible zoom and maximum workspace. And the good thing is this microscope AD207 is 2 years old and it is still working great. So AndenStar offers that great experience. Also, this AD249S records at 2160p, so giving you a better video resolution. So if you want to buy it, link has been provided in the description. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. You get HDMI, switch control for power, USB and lights, and a high speed 32GB SD card, copper side of the SD card, multi-switch micro USB, HDMI. Now power for the focus lights. USB PowerPoint. Turning it on. Nice. Note that you can increase and decrease the brightness with these plus and minus switches. Yeah, now you can see the difference.